بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
مدام اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليك سيدنا القاسم يا رسول الله صلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى اله وصحبه اجمعين. يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: من احب لقاء الله احب الله لقاءه، ومن كره لقاء الله كره الله لقاءه. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says: whoever loves to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves to meet him. And whoever dislikes to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala dislikes to meet him. So Sayyidah Aisha radiallahu anha, the wife of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, قالت يا رسول الله, all of us hates death. Nobody in our life to be dying. Yes? قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, it's not like that. But when the believers receive glad tidings of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Jannah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will love to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But when the person receives bad news that he cannot be among the people of the hellfire, of course is that he will dislike to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala dislikes to meet this person, subhanAllah. We know in the time of the death, the person received the glad tidings from the angels, subhanAllah, that he can go to the Jannah with the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the person himself would like to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the authentic hadith, يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, when the person will be graved, already graved, and then he will find his good deeds represented, you know, like a man sitting with him, and he will ask him, who are you? He will say, I am your good deeds, subhanAllah, in the dunya. And he giving him glad tidings of the Jannah. So the person will say, Rabbi aqim al-sa'ah, Rabbi aqim al-sa'ah. Oh Allah, make the last hour comes. Why? Because he can be in the Jannah, subhanAllah. So the person in the dunya, once he receives the glad tidings of the mercy and the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will love to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But for the kafir, the non-Muslim, the one who do not, subhanAllah, believe in Allah, of course, when you tell him that you will die and meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will say, no, Allah said in the Quran, يَوَدُّ أَحَدُهُمْ لَوْ يُعَمَّرُ أَلْفَ سَنَةً وَمَا هُوَ بِمُزَحْزِعِ مِنَ الْعَذَابِ وَيُعَمَّرُ وَاللَّهُ بَصِيرٌ بِمَا يَعْمَلُونَ. You know, the person or the one who will not enter the Jannah because he's kufr, he would like to stay on the earth 1,000 years, subhanAllah. 1,000 years, you know. Why? Because he think and he know that he will not be among the people of the Jannah. So alhamdulillah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us the Islam, has given us the religion, has given us the guidance. And the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, whoever says la ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah, he will be among the people of the Jannah. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among the people of the Jannah. Amen. And ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive all our sins. Allahumma ameen. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to cover our sins. Allahumma ameen. And ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to deliver to us the month of Ramadan. Allahumma ameen. And to protect all of us from all the evil. Allahumma ameen. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect all of us from the evil. Allahumma ameen. And ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us, our kids, all people, for the right path. Allahumma ameen. Wa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam Muhammadin wa alayhi wa sallam.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن